Hello everyone, and welcome to Provis Gaming and another vlog video! Today we're going to be talking about some upcoming changes to the channel, some of which I suspect will be a little controversial, but I believe are ultimately necessary if I want to continue improving and growing my channel in 2018. I've actually wanted to make this video ever since I hit 100,000 subs, but I wasn't really sure how my audience would react, so I kept putting it off. But now that my Kaiser Reich series is coming to an end, I kinda can't afford to procrastinate anymore, so here goes. I need to diversify my content if I want to keep growing my channel, but that means taking some risks. Now, I've come to this conclusion for a couple of different reasons. First, there's the business side of things. The channel, right now, is performing at an all-time high. The Christmas season in particular was quite nice. You compare me to how I was just a year ago, views are consistently at a higher volume for pretty much anything I put out. I'm quite happy with that, and it's great. Obviously, some series perform better than others, but I digress. Now, you may be thinking, well, if the channel's doing really well, then what do you want to change? Which is a fair question. Well, to answer that, I'll say that I am a big believer that complacency is what destroys channels like mine. I always need to be looking for ways to improve and looking toward the future and trying to predict the market and my audience. I cannot afford to get stuck in a rut producing the same types of content forever because I cannot assume that the same viewers will be there forever to watch my videos as long as I put out the same types of content. I can't assume that. Eventually, people will move on to new types of content as their tastes evolve, and that's perfectly fine. I certainly have done the same thing. Now, YouTubers like me rely on good, steady growth in our subscriber base in order to make up for the subscriber burn, but I don't want to just tread water. I want 2018 to be a year of growth just like 2017 was, but I don't think that I can afford to just keep doing the same things if I want that to happen. That means trying out new things, new genres of games, new types of content. The idea being that new content can try to appeal to a wider audience, more people might be interested in subscribing, and as they stay, they might like me for my personality and want to watch pretty much whatever I do. Of course, the balance here is that as I try out new things, I really don't want to alienate the subscribers that I already have. I have a good, loyal, strong audience, I've really appreciated them, and I want to reward their loyalty. I want to continue making them happy as well. But if I change too much, they may find that they no longer really appreciate me, and then I lose them too. So there's a balancing act between trying new things and pleasing the same audience. I can't say that I know exactly where that balance is. I just know that I'm never going to find it if I just play it safe. Of course, things get really frustrating once you throw in the YouTube algorithm, because as I said, this can be operated like a business, and you have to keep in mind, where's the ad revenue coming from? How does YouTube promote my videos? The YouTube recommendation algorithm actively punishes content creators that want to diversify their content like I do. As a real quick explanation, the YouTube recommendation algorithm exists to try and keep you on their website for as long as possible so that they can make money from ads, which makes perfect sense. I don't blame them for that at all. But that means that they have to keep track of what YouTubers you watch and which ones you decide to skip. Long story short, if you skip several of my videos in a row, the YouTube recommendation algorithm may look at that and say, oh, you're not interested in Provis Gaming anymore, we're gonna stop recommending him and recommend people like the ones you've already been watching. The problem being, even if I do come back to the same types of content that you were interested in the first place, YouTube may not let you know, which means I will never get back to that same viewership that I had before. This exact thing happened when I took a break from Plague Inc. a few months ago, you may remember that. I took a break, I was getting kind of bored of it, I needed to do something different. I was getting a good consistent 20-some thousand views almost per video at that point, and then even when I've come back, it's difficult to break 10. So I kind of lost a huge chunk of my audience, people who still might be interested in it, but they don't know that I'm starting up again. As a result, a YouTuber is encouraged to find a niche on YouTube and then run that treadmill until the day they die, which you can imagine is a little soul-crushing. I mean, I really enjoy grand strategy, and I've built up an audience that enjoys that as well, but I don't want to play that forever. But if I take a break, I'm risking losing my audience and what got me on the map in the first place. So again, it's about balance. I don't know how to find that balance, but I think I need to try. Ultimately, as I said before, I think that I've been playing it safe for too long, putting out the same types of content for too many weeks in a row. I'm gonna need to try some new things, and heck, maybe some of them will even work. And then this brings me to the second reason that I need to change things. my own personal enjoyment. As the channel has grown, I've needed to treat it a bit more like a business. My channel is now at a point where my wife and I actively depend on the income to help pay our bills. But remember, this channel was originally a hobby. It was a passion project, something I really enjoyed doing. And I really, really don't want to lose that. So that means that I need to play games that I actively enjoy and have the freedom to stop a series if I think that it's fizzled out. As an example, my last Crusader Kings 2 series started off really strong. I was having a blast, there was a lot of shock factor, it was great, and people were enjoying it and tuning in, and I thought that was okay, good. So I'll keep playing Crusader Kings 2. And the problem is, I kept doing that even after I kind of got to a point where I'm like, I'm starting to fall into the grind, it's taking a little too long to accomplish things, I'm getting a little bit bored, I should probably stop, but I didn't. Because people wanted me to keep going, and the views were still strong at the time. So I chased the money and the views, and just making some people happy, and started doing content that I wasn't very proud of. But it seems to me that as I started losing my enthusiasm, my audience did too. I'm worried that the same sort of thing could happen with Europa Universalis 4 or with Plague Inc. I mean, if I stop having fun with that, and I feel obligated just to keep going for the sake of it, I don't think that's going to work very well. Chasing the views but not having fun, you guys can sense when that's happening. So no, I don't think that I can afford to keep doing that. I have to focus a bit more on the games that I am personally enjoying. And ultimately, my personal enjoyment and the business side of things are intertwined. If I'm having fun, there's a good chance that my audience will have fun too, even if the game is outside of the standard genre. And on the other hand, if I am playing a game that a lot of people want to see but I'm not enjoying it, I can't imagine my audience will enjoy it either. So between good business sense and then my own personal enjoyment, I think that my channel's future is going to depend on doing something different than what I've been doing. So what does this mean going forward? Well, it means that starting next week, I am going to be taking the plunge, and I'm going to be plunging deep. I have a new series recorded that is either going to go really well for nostalgic reasons, or it's really not. I'm not sure what to expect here, but I think I have to try. It also means that I need to have the freedom to branch out into different genres for games that really do interest me. Bannerlord would be a good example. It doesn't fit any of my current genres, but it's something I'm really interested in, and I'll be excited when it gets released. It also could mean that maybe I want to jump back to some old games from the 90s or the early 2000s, games that I played as a kid that I really enjoyed for nostalgic reasons. And it also means that I really don't think I can afford to play multiple, several-month-long series. And of course, I'm thinking Paradox games. Yes, this means that I probably can't afford to play more than one Paradox game at a time. I have to finish what I've started, and then I can move on to something else. So once I'm done with EU4, then I can move on to a new Hearts of Iron 4 series, or CK2, or Cities Skylines, something that I expect will take me a long time. But even then, I'm thinking that I don't necessarily need to take that game all the way to the end. EU4 has been really fun to play from the very beginning all the way to the very end, but that can take 6 months. In order to do that, and that's just too much the same content. I'm going to have to avoid committing myself to long several month series. I'm gonna have to be able to shorten it down. How that looks for EU4 and stuff, I don't know yet. It may very well be that I will pursue a particular achievement, and then once I've made that, I'm done, and I can walk away and start something new. Or maybe it just means EU4 and stuff like that becomes less prominent on the channel. I'm not quite sure how to balance this out yet. This is just kind of what I'm thinking through. I don't want to stop playing these games entirely. It just wouldn't work for me. I like these games. I do want to keep playing them. I just have to find a new balance. I know this might upset some people who have been supporting me for a long time. Please understand that I deeply appreciate the support you've given me over the last couple years. It has meant a lot to me. I don't even really know how to explain quite how much it's meant to me. I don't want to be one of those YouTubers who changes to be something beyond recognition, okay? If I'm doing that, please tell me. But I also know that I am the type of person who can get so caught up in trying to run an effective business that I will lose sight of what made YouTube fun in the first place. For once, I'm really trying to be authentically me. And once this channel gets to a point where it ceases to be authentic, that's the time that I need to just get up and walk away. We're not there yet, I promise. But I can see the writing on the wall, and I'm trying to avoid it. This is a serious topic, I know. I really appreciate you guys for listening. I promise that I'm receptive to feedback and to criticism. I want to be the best that I can be. I want to appeal to as many people as possible here. So if you think that I'm deviating so far that I've lost touch of myself, then please be honest, you know, let me know. Don't underestimate your feedback, guys. It really does help to make a game enjoyable and to give me a sense of where I need to go. A very meh game can be actually quite fun with the right people. But at the same time, what I would ask of you is that you would accept that I need the freedom to try out some new things and be open-minded. It may just surprise you. Maybe it's going to be fun. Some things are going to work, some aren't. Okay, and if it doesn't, I'll learn from that and I'll try something new. We can have a lot of fun in this together. But only if we're both having a good attitude and coming from a place of trying out new things and just having fun. To that extent, guys, if you want to be able to talk to me directly, one of the best things you can do is sign up to the Discord server, which I will include in the description. It's a pretty interesting community, if not a little eccentric, but yeah, I do try to sign in there more often lately and have some good conversations with people and answer questions. So if you guys have some ideas or some feedback or you think that I'm going off the deep end, great place to talk to me, as long as it's respectful and ultimately with the goal of helping me to be the best that I can be. I'll leave it there. Thank you all very much for watching. I really appreciate it. I hope you enjoy the rest of your weekend. Bye-bye.